Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life out here.
as well as a great life.
Alex, what are you wearing?
What are you talking about?
You know exactly what I'm talking about. You got a little lab coat on, dude. Like, what are you doing?
I don't know, man. I just feel like...
Sometimes I just come in this Freedom Shack and he's just wearing the most ridiculous things.
That is true.
Usually now, I can bully him out of wearing it, but I couldn't this time.
There's also zero times he's ever bullied me out of wearing anything ridiculous.
Yeah, I know.
You can check the facts, like how many weird outfits I've done. Now, I will say, this is not a weird outfit. This is, you know, dress for success, mm-hmm. and I'm dressing not to be sick. So I'm hoping, I've never seen a doctor sick before, so I'm going with that game plan. Plus, honestly, I feel like I'm going to have way better takes on music because of this.
Yeah, you know it's going to be a freaking banger when Alex has a lab coat on, Diet Coke, and Basil Hayden's whiskey.
So I'm either dressed up like a disappointed father because, like, you know, you're not a doctor yet. Mm-hmm. Or, on the other hand, I've been sick for like 2 weeks, so I'm trying to go in disguise, you know? I'm thinking, like, I've never seen a sick doctor.
So we're hitting the Traveling Wilburys. Never heard any of their songs, hadn't heard of this band whatsoever until YouTube, and it's insane because it's a freaking super group.
It is. And now, we looked at this right before we started, mm-hmm. and he goes, never in my life would I, one, think that I would have known the name Traveling Wilburys, but mm-hmm. two, be able to name all five of the members of the supergroup of Traveling Wilburys, which you could.
You got freaking Bob Dylan, yeah. Jeff Lynne, yeah. Tom Petty, Roy Orbison, which we just hit for the first time recently, and then our boy George Harrison, dude. That's insane.
You got all five, five for five.
I could not have named any of them a couple years ago.
I know, and I couldn't even. I'm a doctor.
Dude, I couldn't even have named the Beatles a couple years ago.
That is
which
true.
Is legitimately true and insane.
Yeah, well, now you can. That's called growth and development.
Jesus, man. So,
all right, well, with that being said, we're going to hit this song. Excited? Let's do it.
Being beat up and battered around, being sent up and I've been shut down. You're the best thing that I've ever found. Handle me with care. Reputation's changeable, situation's terrible. But baby, you're adorable. Handle me with care. Been stepping up hordes, terrorized, sent to meetings, hypnotized, overexposed, commercialized, and
Roy Orbison?
I think so. Yeah, for sure.
Everybody got somebody to lean on. Put your body next to mine and dream on. I've been uptight and made a mess, but I'll clean it up myself.
Handle me with care. Huh.
I feel like I have so much to say.
Yeah, same. 1988.
I don't know if that makes much of a difference to me thought-wise. What
it's
is
interesting how it's almost, it's very throwbacky at that point.
Oh, you are
like,
right.
This is almost like the 90s, dude. Mm. Like, it's interesting.
Yeah. Okay. All right, rating. 3, 2, 1.
A.
That's the worst A anyone's ever done in the whole world.
They like had your thumbs poking out, so
that's
it's like
the worst. So even without that, it's like, but how do you is closer. There? How do you do a better one than that? Like this? Oh wait, there's a way to do this like that. Oh, that's a freaking solid.
That's
A.
That's way better.
Okay, yeah, A, easy A. So this isn't breaking any new territory. This isn't doing anything. This is my prognosis as a doctor.
I'm yep.
Oh, I'm, you know why, dude? Illegible handwriting. I'm a doctor, dude. I'm so good at my job. I'm so good at it. Oh my god.
Yay!
So, not breaking any new ground. They're not doing anything crazy. It's interesting to me that this feels more Tom Petty than anyone else in the group. Like,
so accurate.
Writing-wise.
Very accurate.
Maybe it's just this song. Like, maybe this is one that Tom Petty came in and now he's also on the verses. But even the guitar work feels like George Harrison flavored Tom Petty. I didn't expect all the voices to meld so well together.
Yeah, when they first started changing voices, I was like, oh, don't do the thing where you rotate. Don't do the thing. But then it became okay.
Now, here's what I'll say. There's a big trope in modern music, more than any other time, especially for like R&B, rap, whatever, that they have multiple people on songs, and a lot of times they'll have three, sometimes four voices on one song. Mm-hmm. And it flows really, really well when it's done in a modern sense, and I wonder why it doesn't come across so well in a old sense, like with older music. This is one of the few that I think it does.
Yeah, I think part of why is because just like the dynamics, like in new music, a lot of times, like when someone's coming in for their verse, it almost like they drop in like a bomb almost a little bit, or they try to have some type of like dynamic shift where it feels like it's changing
or production effect. Like usually the voice is treated way differently. And in this, and in most songs like back then, it feels like every voice is treated the exact same. Like they're trying to make them seem as like they're singing in the same room. Whereas modern times, it's like usually one will have like a super heavy effect, then no effect at all, then maybe like a weird or different effect.
Also, just like different style too, usually. Yeah. Whereas the styles are usually probably more consistent than. I do agree. I think they pulled it off in this for sure. At first, I was nervous from it, but I think it was really good ultimately.
I did like hearing all the individual voices. Mm-hmm. It felt like they did their own thing, and it did feel like they all introduced their own personal aspect to it.
Yeah, and like you said, it feels like they weren't even trying to make this crazy spectacular thing, but almost make a song where it's like you're bowling, it's a nice background banger, you're playing pool, you're driving, getting a burger, you're doing like you're at a ball game, like anything, like you're in the like the lobby room of like, oh, you're going to a concert, you're like walking trying to find like the area to go in for your seats, and this song is like playing in the background while you're trying to figure out where your seats are at a concert hall. It's like it works literally freaking anywhere. I feel like that was their goal.
I think you're probably right.
It's like easy listening, but also like really cool and like has like some atmospheric like qualities, and they're just kind of like doing their thing.
Part of me is more excited to listen to more of them than almost anything else we have coming up because of the interest of, is every song going to feel like it's Tom Petty inspired? Mm. Like, is his writing influence just so pervasive? Like, maybe you write with Tom Petty and now your song turns into a Tom Petty song. Like, he's got like the infection, dude. He's got the cooties. Like circle, dot, dot, and I got the cootie shot, you know?
I feel like I'm probably as interested to hear more as you are, but probably for a different, I think it's for a different reason.
What's your reason?
It's less of like that and more so I want to see how the individual like bits like kind of just like pop up. Like I want to hear like the different ways in which I see like Bob Dylan influence, or you know, just Bob Dylan kind of pull up, or like Jeff Lynne, how does he play, you know, like just, you know, George Harrison, where do they come in? Because at this point, like hearing this song, like, you know, every song they're gonna like tastefully, especially if they're already doing the vocal kind of like trading off thing, they're gonna have like in various songs where they're just totally doing different things.
Yeah,
and I feel like seeing the individual flavors from them out of their like original bands or their solo work is like gonna be like, will be cool.
Yeah. Well, let us know what we need to do next. And with that being said, catch you next video.
Peace. All right, guys. Thanks so much for watching. If you want to catch some more Andy and Alex videos, go ahead and click the recommended one that's right here for you. And if you want to hang out with us on the Patreon, get exclusive content you cannot get here on the YouTube, click the link right here. See you there. How are you going to cut the one thing out? Because that was like my fifth sentence in my monologue.